I'm Ilyan Saint-Hilaire, and in this video, we're going to look at MeshCentral's integration of the RDP protocol. One of the most important features of MeshCentral is the ability to remote desktop into other computers. And usually that is done through the MeshAgent. And the protocol that we use for going through the MeshAgent is one that is open source, but is, you know, kind of our made up thing. And it is intended to use JPEG to make it easy for browsers. But one of the protocols that's used the most when you're doing remote desktop is RDP, the Windows remote desktop protocol. And so we have integrated RDP into MeshCentral recently. So this video, I want to take a look at that integration. So I'm going to start here by using my trusty MeshCentral server. I have it running right here. I put dash user admin so I don't have to log in. And so it's always logged in as administrator. So now I have a bunch of machines, but I'm going to focus on this AMT machine 15, which is the one on my left that's used all the time. And because it's a Windows machine, when you click on desktop, if you are running one of the latest MeshCentral versions, you will have now two or even maybe three different buttons. You'll have the connect. This is the MeshAgent remote desktop. You have RDP, which is the remote desktop protocol that Microsoft uses in Windows. And then you have Hardware Connect, which is the Intel AMT hardware KVM, if you have AMT. So these three different ways of remoting to the desktop have three, they're three different protocols, but they're very unique in their own ways. So if I click connect on the agent, I will see whatever physical screen there is on the remote side. So here, for example, let's see if I switch, I will see the screen of my PC that I have on the bottom right over here. So basically, you're not creating a new session, you're just taking control of whatever screen you have, you know, in hardware. And that's it. So very simple. And so if somebody's standing in front of that screen, they will see what you can see. If you open, for example, a menu here, or you go in Notepad or so on, then they will see on the physical screen what you see on the remote screen. So that's good. Now I'm going to disconnect. And just before I go into RDP, one quick word on hardware connect. This is Intel Active Management Technology. And this is a layer of remote desktop done underneath the operating system. So in hardware, the management chip basically gets screen captures from the integrated graphics that is in the CPU. It compresses it and sends it over the wire to MeshCentral. So the unique feature of this is that you can see the screen even if there's no agent, even if the OS doesn't work, and you can even boot the BIOS and change BIOS settings. So that's the kind of the unique power of the Intel AMT KVM. But now we have the third option, RDP Connect. And so I'm going to click on it. And now you are asked for credentials. And so you will always need credentials when connecting using remote desktop protocol. So in my case, I'm going to use demo, and I'm going to use my password. And I'm going to hit connect. And I'm going to say remember credentials here, so, and connect. So don't save. And now what you're going to see is, as I connected, the screen on the remote side switched back to the login side. So if you look on the bottom right here, this screen right there is now the login screen, and that's what I'm seeing on the remote computer. In fact, I see it, I don't know if you see it, right there on my left. And so it disconnected the session, and then what it did is it created a new session right here inside my browser. So I am remoting to that computer, but the local user is not seeing my session. So this is not, you know, something you would use for remote support, for example, because it kicks the local user out. But there are some cases where this is very useful, and so RDP is a great offering for that. You know, if you don't want the user to see what you're doing, that's wonderful. So anyway, so this is an RDP session, and it looks and runs just like you would any RDP session with the normal client, except that this is entirely web-based. And so it can be done over the internet, it can go through VPNs, firewalls, and so on. As long as you have a remote agent on the other side, you can do this. Now, a couple of other things that are interesting about RDP is that the screen of the session, the screen size, is not set ahead of time. So if you do an agent connection, remote desktop connection, the screen size here is set to the screen size of the remote screen. But in RDP, this can be set to anything you want. So here, it's set to whatever the canvas size of my browser is. So I have a relatively small display. But if I make the screen bigger, and let's see here, I don't want to crop the top, but if I make the screen much bigger, and I connect with RDP, I'm going to use the save credentials, then you know this is my desktop size right here. Now, I can go in settings, and I can change, and in settings, you can see there's the mesh agent settings for that remote desktop, there's the AMT settings, and there's the RDP settings. And one of the most important settings is size, and so you can say canvas size, so whatever the size of this box is the size that the RDP session will be. But you can also set browser screen size. This is the screen size of your browser screen. So if I say OK and say connect, then what you'll see is that it basically, this is the size of my entire screen, but it's now zoomed out. So it's smaller because obviously it's trying to fit inside the browser. But if I go and I zoom in the browser, then it's getting to the right size here correctly. So that's kind of how this goes. Okay, I'm going to disconnect. You can change basically the select the screen size you want, and you can set a fixed size. So for example, if you want like 640 by 480 and connect, then it doesn't matter what your browser window size is, you're going to get this 640 by 480 window size, and then Windows 10 is trying to adjust for that. Okay, so that's cool. Now, I'm going to go back to canvas size, and then there's a whole bunch of other options here. For example, disabling the white wallpaper, disabling full drag. So if I change these options and connect again, then you'll see the wallpaper is now here. And also if I move Notepad around, you'll see that Notepad is now dragging not just the outline of the window, but the full Notepad window. So these are active by default, but you can change them to whatever you want. So yeah, you can play around with these all you want. And that's pretty good. Now the other things is swap mouse button. That's kind of cute. It's just left and right mouse button swap. The other one is automatic clipboard here. I'm going to get to this one. So I'm going to say okay. So I'm going to bring up Notepad on my local computer right here. And then what I can do is type, for example, Ilian. I can say copy or edit copy here. And then if I try to paste it, it won't work because you need to basically take the local clipboard from my machine and basically copy it over to the remote clipboard. So I have a button here that does that. Actually, this one downloads the remote clipboard to local. So I have to say Ilian, and I say copy. Actually, I'm just going to write my full name just for giggles. I'm going to say copy. Then you can click on this icon to kind of take the remote clipboard and move it locally. And then if I paste it, edit paste, There it goes. The full name is there. Now, the button to push on the other side from local to remote is not available in Firefox. I'm using Firefox right now, but Firefox has extra restrictions. But in Chrome, it does have it. So I'm going to switch over to Chrome here just to demo this correctly. I'm going to open the same window and hit RDP Connect. Server credentials, I'm going to make the window bigger. There he goes. And then you see here, I have both icons, the upload and the download. So now I can basically grab this text, copy, and then I can say, upload it, click. And then when I paste, it should paste both lines, and it does. Perfect. So that's good. Now, the other thing I can do is, instead of using these things, which, by the way, for security reasons, you may want to leave these manual so that you can upload and download the clipboards manually. But if you want to automate this, you can go in Settings, RDP, and you go to Automatic Clipboard, you say OK. And now, when you connect, it will try to auto-sync the clipboards on both sides. So now I say A, B, C, D, E, F. I'm going to say copy, and it should, once I do copy here, then the RDP session notifies the browser that a change has occurred. It sends that, and so then I can hit paste here, and it works. And then if I copy this, the browser routinely polls the local clipboard to see if it has changed. Actually, the polling corresponds to the number of seconds here, so every second it actually polls it. And then if I paste, it pastes the correct string up to here. So that's really nice. By default, it's not on, and really it's for security reasons. You don't want to sync your clipboard to a remote machine unless you know what you're doing. Okay, so that's good. A couple of other things. Yeah, the mouse wheel works. So you can, if you have remote files here, I can scroll the wheel up and down, and that works. And then another thing I want to show is when you connect, there's this little triangle for advanced option, and you can provide an alternate, you can basically specify an alternative shell path and an alternative working directory. And if you do that, that will be sent to the remote, when you start the RDP session. And it's used when you want an RDP session, but instead of having the full Windows shell, you want like a dedicated app inside that session. Now, it does require the remote computer to authorize that app to be run this way. So, and usually you put the full path here and, slash notepad.exe or whatever, and that should work. The other thing is, you may have noticed here, the first time I connected, I was prompted for credentials. And now that I said remember credentials, it remembers the credentials server-wide. So then you can reuse those credentials, or you can click new credentials and specify your new credentials and say remember. If you hit remember, it will only save the credentials if the session successfully connects. So if it fails, if the connection fails, then the credentials you entered will not be remembered. Now, if you do have credentials remembered and you want to delete them, because they're server-wide, you can go in the General tab, and you'll see here credentials. It says RDP, and I can click on the little pen. It says clear RDP credentials. I say OK, boom, and they're cleared. Then I go back to desktop, RDP, and you'll see that the server no longer knows any credentials, and you have to retype them. So anyway, that's about it for RDP integration. I think it's a pretty cool feature. I think it's a great complement to the remote desktop provided by MeshCentral, and also the remote desktop provided by Intel AMT KVM, if you have that. Hope you enjoyed that. Have a great day.